Hello students, welcome to a brand new session of learning. Today we will be learning chapter 1, The Fun They Had, from the English reader Beehive. But before I begin the lesson, I would like to give you a brief overview of what exactly you will be learning during the course of this year. First of all, you will be studying the main course book Beehive and the supplementary reader Moments. Have you read words on a television or computer screen? Of course you have. Who hasn't? With the revolution in technology, we can read almost anything and everything on the internet. Can you imagine a time when all books will be on the computers, that is, e-books, and there will be no books printed on paper? Would you like such books better? Think about it. That's what we are going to read about in today's lesson, The Fun They Had by Isaac Asimov. But before I tell you more about the lesson, let me introduce you to the author, Isaac Asimov. Isaac Asimov was an American writer and professor of biochemistry at the Boston University. He was known for his works of science fiction. He has written more than 500 books. And his short stories are The Fun They Had, Profession, and The Last Question. So let's read the story in detail and find out what this is all about. Students, this lesson is in 10 different sections. So I will read one section at a time and then explain that section to you. Margie even wrote about it that night in her diary on the page headed 17th May 2157. She wrote, "Today Tommy found a real book." It was a very old book. Margie's grandfather once said when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all stories were printed on paper. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awfully funny to read the words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on a screen, you know. And then when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had when they read it the first time. Now here in the first section, we see that there's a little girl by the name of Margie who wrote something in her diary. She wrote that her brother, Tommy, found a real book. Now, why do they use the word real book? Because they were in the year 2157, which is 137 years ahead of us. And at that time, the entire situation would be different. It wouldn't be like we have right now, where you have school and you have computer screens, you read e-books on the screen. But at that time, Margie and Tommy had never seen a real book that was printed on paper. And so they wrote that it was very old. Margie's grandfather said that when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him where all stories were printed on paper. So they found it very peculiar. They had never ever seen a book like that. And when they looked at it, they found that the book was yellow and all wrinkled and crinkly. It was awfully funny to read words that stood still. What was the meaning of that? The books that they had seen, that they used, were e-books that kept on moving on the screen as they read. And when they looked at this book, they found that this was a really peculiar book because the words stood still and they were not used to that. "Gee," said Tommy, "what a waste. When you're through with the book, you just throw it away, I guess. Our television screen must have had a million books on it and it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away." "Same with mine," said Margie. She was 11 and she hadn't seen as many telly books as Tommy had. He was 13. She said, "Where did you find it?" "In my house." He pointed without looking because he was busy reading. "In the attic." "What's it about?" "School." Now here, Margie and Tommy were having a conversation and Tommy felt that having books like this was a waste because once a person finished reading it or studying from it, they had to throw it away. But they felt that the books that they had, all the e-books that they had on the television screen or on their computer screen were very useful because they never had to throw their television monitor, the television screen away, and that could contain a million books. Only thing, since Margie was 11 and Tommy was 13, Margie hadn't seen as many books as Tommy had. And so she said, she asked him where he found the book, to which he replied he had found it in the attic. And she said, what was the topic of the book? Tommy told her that it was about school. So Margie was scornful. School? What's there to write about school? I hate school. Margie always hated school, but now she hated it more than ever. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography, and she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and sent for the county inspector. Now here, Margie was scornful. That means she was very contemptuous. That means she thought that what her brother was saying was just utter rubbish. She said, how could anyone think of writing about school? And the reason she said that was because she personally hated school. There was another reason for that. At that present moment, her mechanical teacher had been giving her one test after the other in geography and she was unable to answer it well, and so she kept faring very badly in geography, and so her mother was also quite concerned, and so she sent for the county inspector. He was a round little man with a red face and a whole box of tools with dials and wires. He smiled at Margie and gave her an apple, then took the teacher apart. Margie had hoped he would know how to put it together again. He wouldn't know how to put it together again, but he knew how, all right. And after an hour or so, there it was again, large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. That wasn't so bad. The part Margie hated was the slot where she had to put her homework and test papers. She always had to write them out in a punch code. They made her learn that when she was 6 years old, and the mechanical teacher calculated the marks in no time. So in this section, we can see that when Margie's mother called for the county inspector, this man came, but he had with him a box of tools, and because he wanted to make friends with Margie, he gave her an apple. And then he took the teacher apart. Margie hoped that he wouldn't know how to repair her mechanical teacher. She thought that she wished that he would take it away and never bring it back again. But it wasn't as she expected. The county inspector, after an hour, was able to put him back again. And so she was faced with her mechanical teacher once again. But the thing that she hated the most was the slot where she had to put in her daily homework and her test papers. Also, there was no suspense. The moment she finished with her test, the mechanical teacher gave her an instant answer. And so everyone could see how she had fared. Now we go to section 5. The inspector had smiled after he had finished and patted Margie's head. He said to her mother, "It's not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quick. Those things happen sometimes. I've slowed it up to an average 10-year-old level. Actually, the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory." And he patted Margie's head again. Margie was disappointed. She had been hoping they would take the teacher away altogether. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because the history sector had blanked out completely. So she said to Tommy, "Why would anyone write about school?" Now here we can see that the inspector, after he had finished repairing her mechanical teacher, he gave her a little pat on the head and he told her mother that he told her not to worry. He said, "Mrs. Jones, it's not your daughter's fault, but the reason why she was faring so badly was because the geography sector was a little too quick for her age." So he told her that he had turned that down. He had slowed it down to the level of an average 10-year-old, and he assured her that from then on she would be doing much better. But Margie was very disappointed. She had hoped when the county inspector came, he would take the mechanical teacher away, and she wished she would never see him back again. The reason she thought like this was that once her brother Tommy's mechanical teacher had blanked out completely the history portion, and so it had to be taken away, and it had not come back for almost a month. So she spoke to Tommy and asked him, "Why would anyone write about school?" Because at that present moment, she didn't like school very much. Now we go to the sixth section. Tommy looked at her with very superior eyes, because it's not our kind of school, stupid. This is the old kind of school where they had hundreds and hundreds of years ago. He added loftily, pronouncing the word very carefully, centuries ago. Margie was hurt. "Well, I don't know what kind of school they had that time ago." She read the book over his shoulder for a while and then she said, "Anyway, they had a teacher." "Sure they had a teacher, but it wasn't a regular teacher. It was a man." "A man? How could a man be a teacher?" "Well, he just told the boys and girls things and gave them homework and asked them questions." Now here there's a conversation going on between Tommy and Margie. And Tommy is reading that old book that they found, and Margie looks over his shoulder and she says that he told her with very superior, in a very condescending attitude, that he knew more than her. Since he was 2 years elder to her, he said that because it is not our kind of school, it was not their kind of school, and he called us stupid for not knowing that. He said that it was not the kind of school that they attended, which was in their own home next to their bedroom. He said this was a school that was there centuries ago. And so she felt very hurt that he had made fun of her. She said that she had no idea about what kind of school they had centuries ago. And then Tommy told her that they had a teacher. And she said, yes, they had. Sure, they had a teacher, because even they had teachers. But he said, no, they didn't have the kind of teachers that we have. He said, the teacher was a man. And so Margie was even more surprised. A man? How could a man be a teacher? They did not have men or human beings as teachers. So Tommy tells her that the teacher was a human being, and he told the girls and boys things, and it was he who gave them homework and asked them questions. In the seventh section, a man isn't smart enough. Sure he is. My father knows as much as my teacher. He knows almost as much, I betcha. Margie wasn't prepared to dispute that. She said, I wouldn't want a strange man in my house to teach me. Tommy screamed with laughter. You don't know much, Margie. The teachers didn't live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. And all the kids learned the same thing. Sure, if they were the same age. Now, here, Margie tells Tommy that how could they possibly have a teacher, man as a teacher, because a man isn't smart enough. But Tommy replied, sure, the teacher was. He says that his father knew as much as his teacher. And Margie didn't want to argue with that because she knew that her father was quite intelligent. So she said that she wouldn't want a strange man in their house to teach her, to which Tommy really burst out laughing. He said, oh, you don't know much, do you? He said the teachers didn't live in the children's homes, but all the kids or the students went to school and the teacher went there as well and taught them there. And that he also added another thing. He said that all the kids learned the same thing if they were the same age. To which Margie replied, "But my mother says a teacher has to be adjusted to fit the mind of each girl and boy it teaches, and that each kid has to be taught differently." Just the same, they didn't do it that way then. If you don't like it, you don't have to read the book. "I didn't say I didn't like it," Margie said quickly. She wanted to read about those funny schools. They weren't even half finished when Margie's mother called. "Margie, school." Margie looked up. "Not yet, Mama." "Now," said Mrs. Jones. "And it's probably time for Tommy too." Margie said to Tommy, "Can I read the book some more with you after school? Here." Margie tells Tommy that how could one person teach all the boys and girls. She said that her mother told her that a teacher had to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and girl as they had their mechanical teachers, and that each child had to be taught differently. So Tommy told her that she didn't need to read the book if she didn't believe what he was telling her. She said that she didn't say she didn't like those books, but she wanted to read about those funny schools. Now, why does she use the word funny? The reason is that when a person is unfamiliar or uncertain about something, they find it very funny. And so before they finish their conversation, Margie's mother calls out to her and tells her to go to the room next door and attend school. And then Margie is in no mood, or she doesn't even have the intention of going there. So she tells her mama, "Not yet." But her mother says in a very stern and firm voice, she said, "Now, and it's probably time that Tommy needs to go too." So Margie asks Tommy if she could read the book for some more time after she finished school. To which Tommy replied, "Maybe," he said nonchalantly. He walked away whistling, the dusty old book tucked beneath his arm. Margie went into the schoolroom. It was right next to her bedroom, and the mechanical teacher was on, waiting for her. It was always on at the same time every day, except Saturday and Sunday, because her mother said little girls learned better if they learned at regular hours. The screen was lit up and it said, "Today's arithmetic lesson is on the addition of proper fractions. Please insert yesterday's homework in the proper slot." So here we can see that when Margie goes to her schoolroom, she asks her brother. And so Tommy gives her a very flippant answer. He says, "Maybe," nonchalantly, and he walks away. So Margie goes into the schoolroom and she sits in front of the mechanical teacher. Now, she had a routine. From Monday to Friday, at the same hour, she had to attend school. Only Saturdays and Sundays were different. And when she entered her school room, the screen was lit up and the mechanical teacher said, which was a robo, it said that that day's arithmetic lesson was on the addition of proper fractions. But before she could begin with the lesson, it asked her to insert the previous day's homework in the proper slot. And so Margie did it with a sigh. She was thinking about the old schools they had when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy. All the kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing and shouting in the schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom, going home together at the end of the day. They learned the same things so they could help one another with the homework and talk about it. And the teachers were people. The mechanical teacher was flashing on the screen, "When we add fractions 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 4, Margie was thinking about how the kids must have loved it in the old days. She was thinking about the fun that they had. So here we can see that even though Margie went into the schoolroom and sat in front of the mechanical teacher, she did so with a very heavy heart. She was thinking not about what the mechanical teacher was teaching her, but in her mind kept flashing all those thoughts that her grandfather's grandfather, in those days, she kept thinking about how wonderful the schools were, that everyone from one neighborhood could attend the same school, and they all went there laughing and shouting and sat together going home at the end of the day, and they could, since they studied the same thing, they could all discuss and help each other in case they had any doubts or problems. And the best part was that the teachers were people. But when she came back, when she came out of her thoughts, the mechanical teacher was flashing. When we add fractions, that means the lesson was in progress, but Margie was miles away from what the mechanical teacher was teaching her. She still kept thinking about the school 137 years ago, when how the students must have loved it and all the fun that they had, because she knew that she did not enjoy school at all. So we come to the end of today's lesson. Students, I would like you to maintain a 200 pages notebook and read the lesson several times. Look at all the spellings that are highlighted, and also note all the meanings that are given, and try and answer all the questions in your own words. In case you have any doubts or need to discuss anything, you can let me know in the next session. So, stay home, stay safe. I'll see you in the next class.